Hello everyone, I hope you all guys are healthy and safe. Dear students, today we are going to discuss circulatory system, physical education class 11, unit 8. Unit 8 is fundamentals of anatomy, physiology and kinesiology in sports. So today we are going to discuss circulatory system. I already prepared the video before it of this unit. If you haven't watched this video yet, you can watch. I have given the link of these videos in the description. So today we are going to discuss about the circulatory system. Now let's start. Every living being requires movement. It may be external or internal. Internal movement requires transportation of materials between various parts of the body. It is termed as circulation and it is known as circulatory system. I hope you understood what is circulatory system. Now let's know a little more about it. Structure and working of heart. Now we will know what is the structure and what is the work of heart. Okay, heart is the part of circulatory system. So now let's start. Circulatory system consists of heart, blood vessels, arteries, arterioles, calipers, veins, venules, and fluid, which is blood. Heart act as a pumping organ and it located slightly on the left side of chest. It is approximately of first fist size. Okay, it beats about 72 times per minute at normal level in an adult. It has four chambers. Okay, heart has four chambers in the upper two parts known as aorta. Okay, the upper two parts of the heart is known as auricles. Okay, there are collection of blood. Okay, in lower chambers known as ventricles. Upper part is known as auricles and the lower part is known as lower two part chambers are known as ventricles. The blood is pumped out. The work of lower chambers is to pump the blood out, and the work of upper part is to collect the blood from the body. So this is the about the structure and working heart. Now let's know a little more about it. The heart has the ability to respond immediately when extra demand is placed upon it. Okay, during heart physical work, the heart rate can increase up to 220 beats per minute. The heart of a trained athlete can pump up to 40 liters of blood per minute. Okay, the heart of a trained athlete can pump up to 40 liters of blood per minute. Now let's know about the blood. What is blood? Blood is a special kind of fluid which acts as a medium of transporting nutrients and gases from one part to body, one part of body to another. Okay, what is blood? Blood is a special kind of fluid which acts as a medium of transporting nutrients and gases from one part of body to another. It also act as a means of communication by conveying chemical messages to various organs and tissues. Blood consists of a colorless fluid. Okay, blood consists of a colorless fluid called plasma. Red blood cells RBC, white blood cells WBC, leukocytes, thrombocytes, and platelets. Okay, these things are found in the blood. Okay, next. And platelets are present in the blood. Okay, these things are present in the blood. There is approximately 5 liters of blood in an adult. Okay, approximately in an adult person, there is a 5 liter blood is found. So this is about the blood. Now let's know about little more terms related to circulatory system. Now the first term which I am going to explain you, which is heart rate. What is heart rate? Now let's know about it. It is a number of contraction pumping of heart in 1 minute. Okay, what is heart rate? It is the number of contraction or pumping of heart in 1 minute. It is about 72 times per minute in normal condition in an adult. Okay, 72 times per minute in an adult. It's a normal. It is also considered as pulse. Okay, we used to say it heart rate. We used to say it to pulse also. It is also considered as pulse. So the second term is stroke volume. Now, what is stroke volume? It is the volume of blood pumped out by heart in 1 beat. Understand it? The heart rate, it is the number of contraction or pumping of heart in 1 minute. And the stroke volume is, it is the volume of blood pump. It is the volume of blood pumped out by, okay, it takes care of this word, blood pumped out by heart in 1 beat. Okay? It is approximately 80 ml per beat in normal adult. It is in approximately 80 ml per beat in normal adult, whereas 10 players have 110 ml beat at stroke volume. So this is heart rate, this is stroke volume. Now let's know about the next step, which is cardiac output. What is cardiac output? Let's know about it. It is the amount of blood pumped by the heart in 1 minute. Okay, now what we said is the stroke volume, it is the volume of blood pumped out by heart in 1 beat. Now the cardiac output, it is the amount of blood pumped by heart in 1 minute. Here 1 beat, here 1 minute. Cardiac output equals to stroke volume into heart rate. Okay, stroke volume is here and the heart rate is this. It is okay, cardiac volume equals to stroke volume into heart rate. It is 5 to 6 liters at basal level. Means basically, this is 5 to 6 liter cardiac output in a common normal person. Okay, in untrained person, it can go up to 20 liter, whereas in the trained athlete, it can go up to 40 liter. Okay, for untrained person, it can go up to 20 liter. And whereas the trained athlete can go up to 40 liters. So these are some terms like heart rate, stroke volume, and cardiac output. Now I am going to tell you about the blood pressure. What is it? Now I will tell you about the blood pressure. Okay, what is it? First know about it. It is the force exerted by blood on the walls of blood vessels while it is moving through them. Okay, what is it? It is the force exerted by blood on the walls of blood vessels while it is moving through them. It is of two types. First is systolic and the second is diastolic. Now let's know about the both one by one. So for the first is systolic pressure. What is it? It is the upper or higher pressure of blood entered on the walls, excreted on the walls blood vessels while traveling. Okay, what is systolic? It is the upper or higher pressure of blood excreted on the walls of blood vessels while traveling. It is during the contraction of heart. Okay, it happens during the contraction of heart. It is 120 mm per hg in normal adults. Okay, the rate of the systolic is 120 mm per hg in adult. So now let's know about the second one, which is diastolic. What is diastolic? It is the lower pressure. Systolic is the upper or higher pressure and the diastolic is the lower pressure of blood while traveling. Okay, lower pressure of blood while traveling. It is during relaxation. It is the during relaxation of heart. Okay, it is 80 mm per hg in normal adult. The rate of diastolic is 80 mm per hg in normal adult. So this is about the blood pressure. So I hope you understood about the circulatory system. Okay, so that's all for today. Thank you. Be happy. Be healthy.
Hey there, subscribe to my channel and also press this bell icon.